ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Judge Manly, the show with your host, Judge Chet Manly.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is the Honorable Judge Manly. Welcome to Chet Manly's courtroom. Today we have a very important case brought to my desk, so I just had to make sure someone would see it. Today we have two people claiming to be the real president. We have Sleepy Joanne, and then we have Donna Supreme, who decided to change her name to real president.
Because
I don't know why we're really here. Neither one of them won the election. We know I won, but you know, for the fun of it, we'll entertain what they have to say. So, please, open the floor, Miss Donna Supreme.
Yes, thank you so much, Judge Manly. Great seeing you again. Hair is looking luscious, as always. I would like to just preface this by saying I am the real president, as you can see in my name listed right there. I am the real president, okay? Sleepy Joanne over here, she's just claiming that she won it, but we all know that she is the least likely person to win it. You know, Judge Manly was a very close second, I do believe, but unfortunately.
No. Do you actually think that the people would vote for a reality star as president?
Hey, watch what you say. This is my courtroom, all right?
Thank you, Judge Manly. It's an honor being here, truly. The American people have been able to grace their TV screens with most of your office and mine at the exact same time. Truly a blessing. God sent. But what I was saying, I'm the real president. End of story. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your opening statement and staying calm for once. You've been in this courtroom many times, so I'm glad you finally learned to be calm. Now, Miss Sleepy Joanne, I will now warn you again, do not attack your judge like that, but you may continue with your opening statement.
Well, as my lawyer has stated, if you see the count, we've counted it many times, and the same results come up. I clearly won the election.
It is a hoax, okay?
This is your first warning.
All right, thank you, Bailiff Camila Harris, who is also acting as our lawyer today, because this is a very poor TV show and we need double the money. So we will bring those vote numbers up. As you can clearly see, they will be presented on the screen. And by a landslide, Chet Manly won, with only you guys receiving 2% of the rest of the vote. So I personally believe I got all those votes, but that's an opinion. We can't have that in my court. So please, Miss Sleepy Joanne, why am I here today dealing with this?
Because she's trying to sue me for a rigged election when apparently I didn't even win, since you are claiming that you won, Chet Manly. Of course, Your Honor.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for finally fixing that. And, you know, I did not quite really care about the election, but seeing as I won, now I'm in here. But beside the point, Miss Donna Supreme, why are you suing her about a rigged election that she didn't even win?
Have you ever heard of a student named Bernie Sanders? Everyone's saying that you should feel the burn. I mean, come on, doesn't that just sound like a fake name?
He got one vote. No, and it was his own vote.
The thing is,
he wasn't even part of this.
You have to know that with fake names like that, people who clearly have been dead for 1400 years, there are fake ballots in here. And so the system in place, all the votes that people said voted for Sleepy Joanne, okay, they're not real people. It's a fake, it's a hoax. And Sleepy Joanne rigged the election. Okay, Chet. Okay.
You're just upset in Mr. Barack's classroom that I'm the favorite student.
Of course I'm upset. Barack had exactly the number of birthday cupcakes that everyone was supposed to be able to have. And you over here saying that everyone gets a fair equal slice of the piece. I was out in the bathroom for a little too long and you decided, oh, okay. You know, Donna's not here. Maybe she won't mind if I just take the extra birthday cupcake. And so I come back and everyone else has got cake on their face except for me. And because of that, Sleepy Joanne, you are dead to me.
Well, you know, in kindergarten, we were friends, man, until you decided to leave me for Pence, okay? So.
Pence smelled better than you. You smelled like.
Hey, nope. None of that. No insults here, all right? No insults about smelling stuff, okay? Or I will force you both to buy Chet's smelly stuff as conversation, as compensation for this, okay? None of that. Now, I want to know what really happened, because you two were just great friends in seventh grade when we were all in that class with Mr. Clinton. Now, we were all in that class, so what happened? What happened here?
Yes, Judge Manley, I remember that class fondly. My biggest takeaway was abstinence does not matter, you know. Denial is key. I did not have sexual relations with that woman. And like that, over here, you know, Sleepy Joanne has clearly taken away the denial that she slept with my boyfriend. Okay. She took him and slept with him and denied it. We had a sleepover and he was supposed to sleep next to me. And instead, she said, come sleep next to me. And she denies it to this day. Okay.
Now, just to clarify, did that happen in kindergarten during nap time?
Yes.
You are fake news.
Okay. That's irrelevant. That's nap time. You guys
She's
had like
spreading all these false things about me. And my lawyer,
do
my
not,
mother can back me up.
Do not interrupt Judge Manley. Do not interrupt Judge Manley.
I apologize. I am so sorry.
Bailiff, you need to keep control of these people. I'm watching you guys. None of that. Now let me finish what I was saying. Now, we all know in kindergarten you maybe had like 3 or 4 brain cells, so that doesn't count. I don't know if you guys have grown any more brain cells, because clearly you guys did not realize you were crappy candidates to begin with. But we're going to continue to entertain this conversation because, well, it's the most viewership we've had in 20 years of the show. So, I want closing arguments now. We will start with you, Sleepy Joanne, as you are the defense.
Well, who would vote for that? Abstinence isn't real.
Really.
Joanne, this is your second warning.
I apologize. I represented what the class wanted, and she clearly could not face that rejection, just like when she was rejected with the cupcakes. I'm sorry, like, it happened, get over it, it was years ago. You refuse to concede, if it's me or our lovely judge, Chet Manley. You don't know what it means to fail, but I can help you with that.
Fair enough. Now, Donna Supreme, what is your closing argument?
I work all night, I work all day to find the boats to save the day, okay? It's a rich man's world, and I have clearly, allegedly rigged this election from the beginning. So, allegedly, there would be a stolen ballot box somewhere with trillions of votes.
The votes have been counted numerous times.
Look, allegedly, you know, you should go check. I really do believe that there is a missing ballot box somewhere with full of votes for Donna Supreme. Okay. And, you know, Hillary Clinton High School was a nightmare from the start. I mean, look at its name, Hillary Clinton High School. But I was going to be able to make this school great again. And I still am. The real president. Okay, I have not conceded. So until I do, I am the real president. And the people of this school in America know that. Thank you, Chet Manley.
All right. I will need just a moment to deliberate on this since we have no jury. So we will have a quick word from our sponsors and then be right back.
We interrupt this program to proudly announce that Chet Manley has decided to join the Just the Tea podcast show, where we spill the tea so you don't have to. Visit us on Spotify and Instagram to find out more. Now back to the show.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I have brought my verdict to the table. As of this moment, I declare this case done. There is no winner. You both have clearly lost the election and just cannot handle defeat. So with that in mind, I have decided to fine you each a total of 50,000 Chet Manly Smelly Bottles to be purchased by both of you. That is your fine. Good day to you both.
It's a hoax.
Now, I expect you both to be nicer to each other in the future. So if you ever end up in my courtroom again, it'll be even a worse punishment. You'll have to buy 100,000 Chet Manly Platinum albums. And we know everybody doesn't want that. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in today to Chet Manly's court case, courtroom special. I, the Honorable Judge Manly, decree that these two are unfit to be leaders anyways. And I, as your new president, will show you a wonderful time at Hillary Clinton High School. Absolutely wonderful. Also, you have both been expelled. Good day.
Oh.
Drums, please.
Here it is, a groove slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm, just a little something to break the monotony of all that hardcore dance that has gotten to be a little bit out of control. It's cool to dance, but what about a groove that soothes and moves romance? Give me a soft, subtle mix, and if it ain't broke, then don't try to fix it. And think of the summers of the past, adjust the bass and let the alpine blast. Pop in my CD and let me run a rhyme, and put your car on cruise and lay back, cause it's summertime. School is out and it's sort of a buzz, but back then I didn't really know what it was. But now I see what habit is, the way that people respond to summer madness. The weather is hot and girls are dressing less, and checking out the fellas to tell them who's best. Riding around.